Okay, so good morning, guys. Today we are going to learn on paano tayo mag-convert ng hexadecimal to decimal. Okay? So, last time na-convert tayo from octal to decimal and decimal to octal, but this time we are going to consider na ang hexadecimal. Okay, guys. So, recommend ko po sa inyo na makinig dito maigi kasi medyo may panibago sa ating computation. Okay? Almost the same lang, pero this time may medyo tricky kasi sa answers natin, ko-consider talaga natin yung decimal. Okay? Or yung point decimal places, okay? So first things first, remember, hexadecimal ay may base yan na 16 and digits niya ay 0 to 9 and A to F. So, paano, ano ba yung digits 0 to 9 and A to F na yun? Okay, so tingnan natin maigi dito sa right side ng screen natin. 0, 9, di ba? Okay, so ano ba ang mga 0 to 9 natin? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Pero, kinoconsider din natin itong A to F na yun, yung letters na yan. In which, di ba, 0 to 9, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Paano kapag 10 na? Paano kapag 10? Ang gagawin dyan, 10 ay katumbas ng letter A. Okay? So, A to 10, B, 11, C, 12, D, 13, E, 14, and F, 15. In which yung F dyan, ay yung 15 na digits dyan, ay pinakamataas na sa lahat. Okay? So, you need to consider that. I-remember nyo yan, guys. So, yan. Kasi kailangan natin yun sa computation natin. But, this time, magpa-flash ako ng parang sa right side ng screen natin. Lalagay natin yung screenshot na yan. Okay? Or yung numbers na yan and letters sa right side para hindi tayo mawala-wala habang nagko-compute tayo. Okay? Okay, so how does decimal digit works? Yan, pa-sys lang natin kanina. 0 is 0. 0 ay katumbas ng 1 ay katumbas ng 1. 2 ay katumbas ng 2. 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8, 8, 9, to 9. Pero paano kapag 10? Paano kapag 10? Paano kapag 10 na? Kasi 8, 9, 10, diba? Yung 10, A na siya kaagad. A, okay? A. So, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A. Okay? A. And B, 11, C, 12, D, 13, E, 14, F, 15. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay? So, ganun, guys. Okay, so mag-convert na tayo ng mga hexadecimal digits. Okay? So, kapag sabing hexadecimal, yung 16 dyan, ay yun yung base na hexadecimal. Paano natin malalaman kapag hexadecimal ang number natin? Either yung may letra siya, or naka-base siya sa 16. And ko-convert daw natin siya sa decimal. Okay, so first things first. Bababa natin si A. Ngayon, isusulat ba natin as A times 16? Sulat ba natin siya? Tandaan, guys. Tandaan. A to 0 to 9, A is 10. B is 11, C is 12, D is 13, E is 14, F is 15. So, isusulat ba natin ng ganyan? No. Kukunin natin si yung katumbas ni A, which is 10. So, susulat natin siya as 10 times 16. Okay? 10 times 16. So, hindi siya direktang letra, but we have to convert it into a real number. Okay? And again, raised to 0. 16 raised to 0 is 1. So, same lang siya dun sa dati natin pagko-compute. Okay? 16 raised to 0 is 1, and 1 times 10 is 10. Okay, goods. And then, kunin natin si 0, baba natin siya. 0 times 16 raised to 1, and 16 raised to 1 is 16, and 16 times 0 is 0. And then, kunin natin si 1, 1 times 16 raised to 2, 16 raised to 2 is 256, and 256 times 1, 256 times 1 is 256. Now, meron pa ba tayong gagawin? Wala na po, sir. Wala na po tayong gagawin. Okay? Pag-add na natin sila. 10 plus 0 plus 256 is 266. So, yun na po yung decimal version ng 10 or 10A na hexadecimal. So what if ganito, 'di ba? What if, 'di ba ito 266 no? 266. What if ganito? Ibang example naman, ibang example. To? Paano naging 11 'yan? Paano naging 11? Kasi hindi na natin siya dinaan sa ano, hindi na natin siya dinaan sa yung pag-write ng letters diyan. Talagang tinignan na lang natin dito. B is katumbas ng 11, 'di ba? B is 11. So sulat pa ba natin siya as B times 16? Hindi na. Sulat na natin siya as as number mismo. So B is equals to 11, which sulat natin yung 11. So ito siya. Kasi B is 11. So 11 times 16 raised to 0, and 16 raised to 0 is 1, and 1 times 11 is 11. So on so forth. Kunin natin si 2, 2 times 16 raised to 1, and 16 raised to 1 is 16, and 16 times 2 is 32. Baba natin si 2, 2 times 16 raised to 2, and 16 raised to 2 is what? 256, and 256 times 2 is 512. Okay, so pag-add na natin lahat, wala na tayong gagawin. Pag-add na natin lahat, 11 plus 32 plus 512 will be 555. Okay, so yan, lagay natin siya sa taas. So that will be our final answer. Okay, so let's try to convert naman ng pabalik. Decimal to hexadecimal. So kanina, hexadecimal to, ano diba? Hexadecimal to decimal. But this time, we are going to convert decimal to hexadecimal. Pabalik tayo, pabalik. Okay, so this time, makinig kayo maigi kasi yung mga, yung pag-explain ko dito is medyo tricky. Okay? Depende sa inyo. So, I require you to listen very carefully. Okay. Kasi dito, i-consider natin yung decimal talaga ng mga kinakalculate nyo. 266 decimal. Bakit decimal yan? Kasi may base siya na 10. Let's convert down natin sa hexadecimal. So, 266. Ibaba natin si 266. Divided by 16. Yung 16 dyan, yan yung base ng hexadecimal. Okay? And then, 266 divided by 16 is what? Try natin dito. 266 divided by 16. Sir, ang sagot ay 16.625. So, isulat na natin agad-agad na 16.625 dyan. No. Check natin yung calculator natin, ha? Okay, ito yung sa calculator. 266 divided by 16 is 16.25. But we are going to write, ngito, mahinig kayo maigi. Kukunin natin tong si 16, bababa natin siya. Baba natin siya. Okay? Kunin natin siya, baba natin siya. And si 625 ay bababa rin natin. Okay, so si 0.625, tanda nyo, 0.625, mumultiply natin yan kay 16, na si 16, which is ito yun, yung base ng hexadecimal, okay? Hindi ito yun, ha? Ito yung 0.625 multiply natin sa base ng hexadecimal. Okay, so anong sagot dyan? 0.625 times 16 is 10, diba? So, 10. And, ito, susulat na natin siya dito sa tabi ng 266 divided by 16. Okay? Equals to 16R10. Sir, bakit 16R10? Ganyan. So, ganito. Ginawa natin 16, binaba natin siya, and si 625 ay minultiply natin 16, which is yung outcome niya ay 10. Okay, so sulat mo siya as ganito. 16 remainder 10. Okay, so yan na ba yung final answer? Dito ay yan na ba yung sagot dito sa 266 divided by 16? No, not yet. Kasi si remainder 10 gagawin natin siyang ganito. So sa tingin niyo anong katumbas niya diyan? Yung 10, saan ba dito si 10? Yun ay si A. A is equals to 10. So ito magiging A yan, magiging A. Okay? So magiging A siya. So 16 parang 16R10 siya, 16RA siya, ganun. Okay, so since okay na yan, baba natin si 16. 16 divided by 16 is what? 1 remainder 0. Kasi wala tayong decimal. Pag naging remainder 0, wala tayong decimal, okay? 16 divided by 16, 1 lang. Wala siyang point something something. Okay, so yun, sulat natin as remainder 0. And then baba ulit natin si 1 divided by 16 again equals to 0 remainder 1. Okay, so 1 divided by 16 is 0 remainder 1. Okay. So bakit naging remainder 1 'yan, guys? Bakit naging remainder 1 'yan? Okay? Bakit naging remainder 1 'yan, guys? Kasi kapag multiply dinivide natin siya 1 divided by 16. So 0.0625 and then yung kukunin natin yung point diyan, yung 0625 sa calculator natin. 0.0625 multiplied by 16. So 0.0625 times 16 is 1. Okay, so yung 1 na yun, susulat natin siya dito. Okay? Sulat natin siya dito. Okay, so again, dati, paano ba tayo magbilang ng sagot? Especially kapag nakikita nyo yung divide dyan. And may mga remainders tayo. Pataas tayo magbibilang ng sagot. Okay? Pataas tayo magbibilang ng sagot. Okay, so ang sagot natin dyan ay 10A. Okay, 10A. 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 So yan na po yung final answer. Okay? Okay, so yun. Thank you for watching and I hope nakapag-take down notes kayo, guys. And sorry sa mga inconvenience. And I hope you have enjoyed this video. Comment down your attendance mamaya, guys. Thank you.